really hope there's no ice on this road, otherwise I will be in a horizontal position. I'm out, I think it's 0 degrees today, and for some reason I decided to wear the most slippery boots that I have, which actually have a small heel in them, on them, at them, with them. They have a small heel. And I'm walking by, I think, is this like a botanical garden or something? And I have 4 layers of clothes, which is so funny. I have a little ultralight underneath, a wool coat, and then I also have a sweater and Uniqlo Heattech top and leggings and everything, like all the equipment. So it's actually pretty pleasant to walk in this whole thing. I quite enjoy the fact that we can experience the winter at least for a few days. Oh my gosh, it's snowing. It's snowing from the trees. Yeah, I love that we can experience that a little bit more. Is it a bamboo or something? I don't know, because I actually missed the snow in the New Year's so much that it didn't feel like New Year's at all, unless there were Christmas lights on. So I quite enjoyed that for 2 days. Myself some Zara sale order. Let's open it up. I don't know if I am spoiled for some Zara shopping, but it became so inconvenient. They don't have any store deliveries, at least here in Serbia. So yeah, I've been collecting some items. It's actually just 2 items that I was able to collect throughout this time, because usually, like, why is it so inconvenient? Because usually, out of my long wish list, I only have available like maybe 1 item, and for me to pay for delivery for every single item is just not convenient, because I don't even know if those things will suit me or not, if they will fit me or not, because they don't even have those items in stores. I don't know, Zara, why have you done this to me? So basically, out of this order, there's 1 t-shirt that I've already tried on, and then the other thing is the pair of some loafers that I haven't tried on because they didn't have it since the beginning of the season. So let's open it up. I hope I don't need to return them. I hope. Okay, why am I so bad in opening the boxes? Okay, I'm done. Okay, my t-shirt is this one. I don't have anything in this color, and I just wanted, I tried it on in store. It has a huge, huge California texting on the back. I like it. Is it the size small? Yeah, this is the size small. This one, I know. Okay, let's see. They don't have a box, which I'm fine with. I love that they have this dust bag. Ooh, those are cute. Are they cute, aren't they? They're my size. Let me try it on. Oh my gosh, I hope they fit. Let's pray that they fit. They fit. Let me try the other foot, because I have different feet. 1 foot was under surgery and the other one was not under surgery. So the moment of truth. Yay! They fit so well. I think that not a lot of people will like them because they are pretty masculine, but I already have like narrow looking, more feminine loafers. So I think those are pretty cool. I wouldn't want to go for something more, I don't know, edgy maybe. And then you can see the t-shirt, which is California on the back, which I'm really happy about. I usually roll up the sleeves to make it a little more accurate for my feminine body. Pretty like beigey lemon color. I think it's pretty cool. Today
we are becoming a very interesting type of family, which is pre-revolution Orthodox family. We are gonna celebrate the old new year. Let me explain. So basically, before the Russian Revolution, we had the old type of calendar, which was Julian calendar. So when the revolution happened, the new politicians decided to change the calendar from the Julian one to the Gregorian one. But then the church calendar hasn't really changed, so all the religious holidays basically stayed the same for the same dates. That's why we have the gap between the Catholic Christmas and Orthodox Christmas. I think the gap is like 14 days or something like that, which means that the new year on January 13 to January 14, I hope it does make sense. So if this is not the actual like official holiday, but people in Russia, they do celebrate it because we love to celebrate the New Year's in all the different forms. We love to celebrate all the New Year's stuff so much that we actually need to drink to let the old year go. Let me explain. You know, like when your guests come over, but when the evening is already like coming to an end, you kinda escort your guests to the exit. This is what we do with the old year. We kinda hold the glass and say all the words like, this year has been very, very difficult, but we became stronger and we hope that the next year will be easier. This is what we say to basically let the old year go. That's why if we have another case of celebrating the New Year's, we will use it. So today is the day. We're gonna have some fish for dinner, which is marinating right now. I'm also cutting the potatoes, and something that I did is this huge bowl of the Russian salad, which we're gonna eat in a few days, I think. This is the last time we're eating it for the year, I think, before the next year.